The following interview was conducted with the library's Diversity Fellows 2006 to 2008, Marissa Alicart, LaTanya Jenkins, and Valerie Yazzo for the Purdue University Oral History Program. It took place on Friday, July the 24th, 2008 in Stewart Center, B26. The interviewer is Catherine Marquis, the Oral History Librarian. There will be separate interviews, but they'll all be on the same tape. And the first one is Marissa. Welcome. Tell us where you were born and your parents and your siblings in early years.
I was born in Tucson, Arizona. I'm the youngest of eight siblings. So I grew up in Tucson, spent most of my life there. Some in New Mexico also. That's where my parents were from originally.
Okay.
And they kind of moved there, and I was born in Tucson.
Tell us about early years in high school.
Did you go to school
in Tucson?
Yes, I went to school from elementary, high school, middle school. They were all within like walking distance of where I grew up. And all my siblings went to the same high school, and
So kind of. What was any activities in high school, or athletics, or what?
I would say my graduating class was probably about 900. I would say, it's a pretty large school.
Was it 4 year?
Yes, it was 4 years. Activities, I was kind of involved in chorus for a while, which is kind of a strange thing because I wasn't very into the arts, but that was kind of, it was really a good experience because it kind of helped me with confidence and just, you know, being in front of people. Also really involved in yearbook for like 4 years, so
sure.
I was on the yearbook committee, so that was kind of.
Now, let's talk a little bit about college. Tell about student organizations and athletics and your course of study. Were you a commuter or resident? And
I went to school at the University of Arizona, so that was also in Tucson, so I lived off campus and kind of just went in when I had classes. I studied anthropology. It was emphasis in archaeology, like Southwest archaeology, so I thought I was going to be an archaeologist for a while. Also studied Mexican-American studies as like a minor. I was kind of involved mostly in like anthropology, archaeology clubs. I wasn't very into like the athletic part of of college. So
how about field trips? Did you go on any? Did they take you on field trips for that?
Yeah, I actually did. I actually was in field school for archaeology. So my last summer when I was a senior, I actually did field school through Arizona, University of Arizona. So it was like a 3-month field school, and we were up in northern Arizona. And so that was a really good experience. Kind of did survey and excavation, and so yeah.
Very good. Yeah. And then tell us what about graduate education, your professional education. What happened after you graduated from high school or college?
Undergrad. I kind of went into the job market. I was working at a preschool for a while after graduating, and looking at graduate programs for anthropology. But I was also interested in archives because I had done some internships in archives when I was in undergrad. So I kind of started looking at library school, and they had a really good program at Arizona. It's called Knowledge River. It's to promote Latinos and Native Americans into librarianship. So one of my friends had graduated from that program a year before, and she kind of recruited me. And since I was interested in archives, I kind of thought that would be a really good experience. So I applied and was accepted.
Okay.
And that's how I,
tell us about the archives. Where did you work when you were in college as a student? You said you worked in some archives.
I was at Arizona, at Special Collections of Arizona. So I did a graduate assistantship there for about a year and a half. And
worked on... What sort of collection did they have there?
A lot of the collection is based like on Southwest, you know, stuff that's coming out of the Southwest. But it's also... they have congressional collections as well. So one of the congressmen, Dennis DeConcini, he's from Arizona, he had just donated his papers. So that's what I was working on most of the time there.
Good.
Processing his papers, yeah.
Oh, sounds like a good deal. Mm-hmm. Then after, what was your career path before you came to Purdue for the Diversity Fellow Program?
Well, I had finished library school, and I was kind of looking at public, but also academic, mostly because I was... part of ARL, the Association of Research Librarians. I was one of their scholars my last year of grad school, so that kind of tried to focus us on academic librarianship, and through that we came to Purdue to visit, kind of get a intro to academic libraries, and that was where I met, you know, everyone here, and was kind of recruited into the new fellowship position. So
okay. Well, that's what I was going to, then my next questions have to do with that. How did you hear about the program and what prompted your interest in it?
Well, I heard about it initially from Jerome Oford, who is like the director of ARL Initiative to Recruit a Diverse Workforce. Uh-huh. And also when we came here, we did hear about it again, that they were actively recruiting for the fellowship. So I kind of talked to Rebecca Richardson and kind of got a more information on it.
Sure.
So that's how I heard about it.
Well, that prompted your interest in it. Mm-hmm. And how does that fit into your career goal of being affiliated with a research university, do you think the program does?
Well, I mean, the fellowship has definitely given me hands-on experience working in an academic library. I've been here 2 years, so you're in school and you kind of get a lot of theory, so it's been great being able to actually be a librarian in an academic institution. Mm-hmm. So it's been a good experience.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Can you just make a couple comments on your capstone project, it might, for the researchers, you might just tell them a little bit what that term meant as it applies to your program.
Okay, capstone project. Well, our first year was kind of doing various rotations in other libraries, kind of getting an overview of academic librarianship, and our second year was focusing on promoting programs or creating programs that would promote diversity within the libraries, and also kind of creating outreach from the libraries to other underserved communities on campus. So I focused my capstone on working with the Latino Cultural Center on campus, doing just like creating sort of an outreach program. And they also have a book collection there that I've been working on, kind of helping them catalog it, organize it, so that they can have more use of it. It's a small collection, but it's kind of a really good resource, mm-hmm. I think, that many people don't know about on campus. Also, working with the HISI librarians on like collection development, and also kind of being a liaison to the Latino and Latin American Studies program. That's a new program that's starting in this coming fall. It's going to be a minor program. So just working on kind of boosting the collection to support that. Doing workshops to like show key resources that we have in that subject area, and also working on subject guides for that. So mm-hmm. that's kind of what I've been doing for the last year.
You might, for the researchers, say that this center has not been on campus for long.
So Latino Cultural Center.
Really,
I think on campus. I think they just celebrate their fifth anniversary this past year. So
but
it's pretty fairly new.
A lot of the facilities
new.
And things that you've done have built, you know, you've really added on
to
it.
Well, I hope so.
Especially
I hope it's
the
made
library.
A difference.
How about an overview of the program in your own words? Care to make any comment?
The fellowship program?
Yeah, right.
Well, I think it's just a really great program for someone who's coming out of library school and doesn't really, is interested in academic librarianship, but doesn't really know the area they're interested in. I came in kind of thinking I was going to focus on archives, and I did work in the archives here, which was really a great experience, but I was also kind of gained interest in other areas, such as like reference and just outreach also, which I hadn't really had much experience in before. So I think it's a good way to kind of get your foot in the door, and also just gain real-world experience, and also explore, you know, other areas that you may potentially have interest in. So.
Did you visit any other, are there any similar centers in the state? Did you visit, were there any of the schools?
I didn't visit any similar centers within the state. When I was at some conferences, I did visit, like, a center in Dallas. It was the Latino Cultural Center, and it's kind of similar. It was an academic center. It's kind of based in the city, but... No, I haven't. I hadn't really visited anything here in Indiana.
Okay. Now, one couple comments on the advisory board. Did you interacted with them during your visits?
Yeah, we did interact for the fellowship advisory board.
Right. Yeah.
Yes. They came. I think they came to visit at least twice while we were here. I knew three of them before they were on the advisory board. One of them, Jana, was the director of my library school, so I knew her. And Jerome was, director for ARL, and Camila I had known before also.
Sure.
It's a good experience, kind of telling them kind of the strengths and like concerns we had about the program, and also just ways to strengthen it over time, and I think they're really great at taking our feedback and like also giving feedback to us on what we could work on in the future. So
very good. Okay, now did you serve on, how about library faculty search committees? Were you able to serve?
I did.
Tell us a little
serve
bit about
on
the researchers and.
I did serve on one faculty committee. It was for a business reference librarian at Management Economics Library. So they did work on that one for a while.
Yeah
it was a good experience, kind of looking at being able to look at the other end of it, since this was my first professional job, and going through that process, but being able to see the other end of what it takes to be on a search committee. So it's kind of giving me an inside look at, now that I'm applying for new positions. So.
Were there any other committees that you served on while you were here?
I think that might have been the only one as far as the library.
Okay. You attended some professional associations. Would you comment on one or two that you seem to favor over another, or got something out, or just a general comment on some of the professionals like ALA?
Like the conferences and
right,
that sort of thing.
Right, that you attended, comment on one.
Well, one of the ones that I really enjoyed, I attended last year, the beginning of last year, and it was a joint conference for librarians of color. And I think it was the five ethnic caucuses of ALA that joined, that had this one conference. It was really good because it was smaller, and it was in Dallas. And it was just a good experience, kind of being able to kind of talk to other librarians that were in similar situations or had similar backgrounds, and kind of getting feedback from them on librarianship in general. And
Good networking.
Good networking, definitely right. Good networking.
Yeah. How about since you've been here, do you have a favorite Purdue tradition or any tradition that sticks in mind?
Favorite Purdue tradition? Oh, gosh.
Or you can either do that, or how about an outstanding event in your life? You think
in the last 2 years?
Or not in the last, in general.
An outstanding event? Oh, wow. I can't think of anything offhand.
You've got so many you can't think of them, right? Okay. Well, how about any advice that you want to give to future diversity resident librarians, because they're changing the title a little bit for researchers, I've mentioned that.
I would just say come into the position with an open mind. Like I mentioned before, I kind of came in thinking archives, and that's kind of where my focus was, but I think you definitely need to come in being open to new experiences and also new areas of the profession and different avenues of librarianship. Just be open to experiencing as much as you can while you're here. Within the libraries and also just the community, I think just getting involved is really great. I've been really involved with the Latino Cultural Center and also La FASA, which is Latino Faculty and Staff Association on campus, and they've been a really great support to me my 2 years here. So I would just say just come with an open mind and learn as much as you can while you're here.
Any topics that you want to refer to, or any closing comments that you'd like to say? Anything special comes to mind? What's the next step?
Next
stage is American Express or
next stages. Right now it's kind of up in the air, but I definitely know I'm staying in librarianship. I mean, that's like the profession that I really know that I'm going to stick with in the future. I'm hoping to get back to the Southwest, closer to home and closer to my family. So that's kind of the next step right now.
Okay, good. Thank you very much,
Marissa.
Thanks a lot.